Hey guys, welcome to What's Cooking in My Kitchen's 5 Minutes to Fabulous, the new segment in our show where we show you how to make something great in about 5 minutes. Salads, appetizers, main courses, desserts, and a few other special things that are quick and easy and meant to impress. I mean, people are going to think you spent hours in the kitchen slaving and slaving, but you're not. And that'll be our little secret. So come on, the clock is ticking. Let's roll up our sleeves and get fabulous in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
C'è la luna e mezzo mare, mamma mia, mi mare da te. Figlia mia, cotta dure, mamma mia, te pensa tu. Si tu rulla gangare, e dove vai, e dove ne, sembra un sassi e c'è manetene. Se ti piace i maccheroni, mi piace spaghetti pure. La la la, la 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 la, la la la, la 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 la, la la la, la 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 la, la 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 la, yuhuhu, paisan! C'è la luna e mezzo mare, mamma mia, mi mare da te. Figlia mia, cotta dure, mamma mia, te pensa tu.
Hey guys, welcome back to 5 Minutes to Fabulous. We've got a delicious appetizer lined up for you today. It's brandied shrimp with capers, and you're gonna love it. It's a perfect appetizer that can be served ahead of any gourmet dish, whether it be meat, seafood, or poultry, it doesn't matter. It's delicious, you're gonna love it. And it can be done in about 5 minutes. So without further ado, let's put this thing together and eat something delicious. Come on. Okay, this is a real easy recipe with simple ingredients. We're gonna start over here with our shrimp, which I pre-peeled, but I've left the tails on for presentation and decoration when we're done. As you can see, I got 10 shrimp in here. Now, depending on how many people you're cooking for will determine how many shrimp you need. When you go to plate this up, you wanna put about 5 or 6 shrimp on per plate, so that'll let you know how many shrimp we need. So other ingredients we're using for this dish, there's some fresh chopped basil, which I'm gonna do here in a second. I'm gonna have some fresh squeezed lemon juice. I'm gonna be using sea salt and fresh ground pepper. We got some capers we're gonna use, some fresh virgin olive oil, and then we're gonna serve it on a bed of fancy red lettuce and some radicchio. Now the very special ingredient in this dish is Christian Brothers brandy. That ought to cure what ails us, huh? Absolutely. So I'm gonna get cooking this and get fabulous in 5. All right, here we go, guys. What we're gonna do to start with is we're gonna take about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Now, I don't measure stuff usually, but that's about 2 tablespoons, just enough so you get a good coating on the bottom of the pan. And then we're gonna put our shrimp in there, just like so. Just pop them in there. All right, and then we're gonna use some sea salt. I'm just gonna do a nice pinch of sea salt. That ought to be enough. We don't want to go too crazy. That's good there. And we're also going to use some fresh ground pepper, of course. So we'll do the same thing, about a nice pinch of ground pepper, just like that. Perfect. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to put on medium heat here. Don't want it too hot because we don't want to scorch the olive oil or burn the shrimp. Basically, it's about 2.5 minutes until the shrimp start to turn a golden reddish pink color, and that's when you know the shrimp are ready to move on to the next step of the recipe. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add the capers. We're going to add 2 tablespoons. There's 1. There's 2. Doesn't have to be perfect. That's good. And we're going to add our chopped up fresh basil, just like that. And squirt our lemon juice in there. There we go. Let's squirt that all in there.
Perfect. Stir that around a little bit. All right, these guys are cooking up real nice, so now we'll add our brandy. And we're going to use about a quarter cup, which in my estimation, is a couple nice pours. So just like that, that's about a quarter cup right there. So now we'll just let that cook just a little bit more. We'll let this come to a boil. So we're going to turn the heat up. So we're going to simmer this for just a couple minutes. Bring the heat back just a little bit. And let's get our plate ready. So what we're going to do is we're going to take some of this redhead lettuce here. We're just going to pull off some nice leaves. And we're just going to kind of put them around the plate like so. Just like that, all nice and pretty like. Let's get one more leaf here, make it look real nice. There we go, just like that. And we're going to take some of our radicchio, which is our little red lettuce here, and pull off some nice pieces. Look how nice and colorful this is. Not only is this colorful, it's delicious. So we'll set that on there, just like that. And one more leaf. There we go, just like that. So now we're going to set our shrimp right in there. All right. All right, looks like our shrimp are done. Oh, look at them sizzling. Mmm, nice and pink. Oh, the flavor smells great, guys. All right, so we'll cut the heat here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to push the shrimp over to the side for a second, and I'm going to try and scoop out some of the goodies in here, some of the basil and capers, drain some of the juice, and we're going to set that here in the base of the lettuce. And we're going to set our shrimp on top of that. And drain off as much juice as we can. Just spread that around nice. All right, then what we're going to do is we're going to take our shrimp, and we're just going to carefully set them in a nice little formation, just like so. And then we'll put this nice big one right on top, just like that. And then we'll just give it one blessing of the sauce here. Not a lot, just a little bit, about that much. And we'll just put it over top. There we go. All right, guys, there you have it. Our fabulous and five appetizer, brandy shrimp with capers. Doesn't that look delicious? I assure you it is. Well, I'm going to go eat this bad boy because I'm starving and I can't stand to let it sit there another second. So if you want any of the recipes for any of these fabulous five dishes I've got, just feel free to email me or hit me up on Facebook and I'll be glad to send them all to you. So until next time, bon appetit!